The protests at Parliament included many Māori. You probably saw Tino Ranga Tiratanga flags and Māori iconography. And one party says many Māori were used as pawns by the alt-right during the occupation. Rawiri Waititi is the co-leader of Te Pāti Māori and he joins us now live. Tēnā koe, thanks for being with us on Q&A. What was your overriding feeling as you watched those scenes on Wednesday?
Well, actually, before Wednesday, from day one, you could see there was a sense of a different wairua about this particular protest. And so by the time Wednesday had come along, yes, we've got to look at the core of what the reason why many of our people were at that protest. And so I mentioned in a speech in Parliament about the core of this for many Māori is colonisation. And colonisation has played its part in terms of the degradation of our mana, motuhake, and our tino rangatiratanga. But let's not get that confused with the freedom marches all around the world, because they are two very different things. You talked about the iconography. Trump flags, Confederate flags should never ever fly with tino rangatiratanga and he whakaputanga flags. The Trump flag and the Confederate flags, they have been there and have actively campaigned against the oppression of Indigenous and Black peoples all over the world. If you look at Trump's comments, about Mexican immigrants and being criminals and rapists and Muslims, wanting to stop Muslims from migrating to the US, all of those types of things should never have a place, and that rhetoric should never have a place here in Aotearoa, and they should never ever fly with tino rangatiratanga and mana motuhake.
So Rawiri, why were there so many Māori at the protest, do you think? And why did we see tino rangatiratanga flags at the protest?
Because our people have been used in regards to there's a difference between tino rangatiratanga and mana motuhake. Those particular kaupapa we have been fighting for 182 years, and that's the sovereign rights under the Tiriti o Waitangi. These freedom marches, if you look at the impacts of mandates in the last 6 months, they do not compare to the 182 years of plight that the iwi Māori have been fighting for. And so this is the problem, is that our people and those particular kaupapa have been used to push this particular agenda. Yes, yeah. I have a aroha for our whānau that have been impacted by mandates, and we need to do something about that. And to note that we were the only party out of five in the whole of Parliament to vote against mandates because of that very reason.
Let me ask a bit more about that then. Do you think if mandates hadn't been introduced, we wouldn't have seen the protests at Parliament?
No, I don't, because I think the protests had a mixture of a whole lot of other things. Mm. And so as you saw the rollout of the vaccine throughout Aotearoa, there were many people who were disgruntled by the vaccine. There are many other ideologies out there that is created through conspiracies and misinformation. And so I think the mandates is one thing, yes, and I totally agree with that. The government mandate should not have happened. There should have been a wider discussion with marae, with iwi, who actually had their own processes in place before there was vaccination in the first lockdown back in 2 years ago. And so what we were saying was put the mana back into whānau, put the mana back into those organisations to be able to make up their own tikanga about how they engage with their people. In terms of the protest, I think there was a mixture of a whole lot of other things happening there. And if you peel away the mat, you will find that there was more than just anti-mandate.
Your former party co-leader, Marama Fox, attended the protests, and of course your party's founder, Tariana Turia, expressed support for the protests. Why was that?
I can't control past leaders and past presidents of our movement. And so there were parts of the protest, like I said, the anti-mandate stuff that we were totally supportive of. But not going down to that protest doesn't mean we didn't hear our people. Like I said, we were the only ones that put out a policy around the lifting of government mandates. So let's get some perspective on this. Debbie and I are only two out of 120 MPs. We're only one party out of five. Yeah. That are continuously pushing these boundaries. And just to note, we have been on many a front line of many protests. We are just in the front line of a different protest as activists now, and that is in the front line of the Chamber of Representatives.
So you said earlier, though, you said in your speech in the House on Thursday that you believe many Māori had been used as pawns by the alt-right during these protests. So do you think that Marama Fox and Tariana Turia have been misled?
No, because their very core of their reasons for supporting this kaupapa was around the mandates. The other one is around choice. And so we've been pro-choice, we've been pro-vaccination, and we've been anti-mandate. We've been very, very clear on that. Mm. And so the choice for people to make those decisions should have been to the people themselves and not being forced by mandates. And so, look, you know, we've had people on the ground at that protest. Jack, you know, listening on the ground to what was happening there. We've had many people threaten our lives and the lives of our whānau. And, you know, many people weren't following the health guidelines either. Nobody was wearing masks. There was no leadership. So being called down to that particular protest meant who were we meeting with? Mm. How was that going to happen? Many people, yes, okay, there were some people that wanted us to go and listen to them, but there were others that wanted targets, obviously. Yeah. The first 2 days of that protest, I listened and watched from my office window, and I could see they had written on the concrete, hang them high. They wanted to execute us, not just us, but also the media. And so my whānau made the conscious decision to say, do not go down there. Do not put yourself at risk. But to know everybody out there is that we stood up against mandates and we will continue to do that, even though there is no protest outside of Parliament today.
Rawiri, I'm going to ask you a very difficult question. After a divisive incident like this, how do you think we go about trying to reunite the country?
I think that's a big question, Jack, and we need to look at. I think the biggest part for the best unity of this country is actually to go on to Tiriti o Waitangi, and now let's start looking at constitutional transformation for Aotearoa, where tangata whenua and tangata tiriti can come together and make equal and equitable decision-making for all. But right now, we need the government to adopt some of our policies within our COVID-19 response policy. We need to speed up the establishment of a Māori health authority. We need to transfer all Māori targeted DHB vaccination program funding to Māori health, whānau ora and iwi providers. We need to share the vaccination data with Māori health and iwi providers so we can have a targeted approach to dealing with our whānau out there. We need to ensure ethnicity data across all COVID-19, including travel exemptions of MIQ applications, are collected. We need more resource into home isolation, Jack. Many of our whānau, they will be locked out of their mahi, could be for months, depending on how many are there. And we also need a support package for those who have been impacted by the mandates. So you can't say you've got no job, no jab, no job. We need to put some resources beside them. We need to work through this together, and we need to start looking at how we can start to bring the country together by ensuring that we leave nobody behind.
Tēnā koe. We always appreciate your time. Thank you so much. That is Rawiri Waititi, the co-leader of Te Pāti Māori.